Hello students, today we are going to learn how to model a gear train arrangement. As all of you know that when more than one gear is arranged together for transmitting torque or power from one system to another system, then the arrangement is called gear train. This arrangement is formed by mounting gears on a frame so the teeth of the gear engages. Gear teeth are designed to ensure the pitch circles of engaging gears roll on each other without slipping, providing a smooth transmission of rotation from one gear to the next. In our diagram, we are having two gears. In our diagram, we are having two gears. Now, one is bigger gear with having size of radius R1 and teeth provided on it is N1. Similarly, it is a smaller one. And it is having a radius of R2 and having teeth of N2. This wheel, we will call it as a driver wheel, and this one will be the follower wheel. Now, we are applying Tm amount of torque on the driver wheel. And the wheel moves for theta amount of displacement it is moving. We all know change of state is always opposed, so the displacement of theta 1 of the wheel will opposed by the displacement of this theta 1 by the wheel will be opposed by the inertia J1 and the frictional coefficient B1. Therefore, a torque equation we can able to write is this. Tm is basically opposed by the frictional coefficient due to displacement of theta 1 and the viscous friction present around the wheel is B1 theta 1 dot. And we got the amount of torque left is T12, which we can able to take as an intermediate torque, which is actually applied on the follower wheel. Now, let us calculate the work done by the first wheel. T12 is the torque responsible for the movement of the second wheel. So, work done by the first wheel is T12 into theta 1, which is equal to the work done by the second wheel. The second wheel is having angular displacement of theta 2. So, amount of torque upon it is a very different from T12. So, we are considering it as T21. Now, as the first wheel is actually working on the second wheel, so the amount of work done is same. And we can consider that T1 to theta 1 is, so we can able to calculate the amount of length they traverse in the interlocked condition is theta 1 R1. For the first wheel and theta 2 R2 for the second wheel. As they are interlocked and having the same path, so theta 1 R1 can be equal to theta 2 R2. So, from that we can get this relation. So, we get a relation initially initially we got that this torque intermediate, the relation between this intermediate torque and theta 1, theta 2. Next, we got the relation with the theta with the radius. Now, as we know, the radius is proportional the radius, the number, we can understand that the number of teeth can be is proportional to the radius. So from that we can also get the third equation. This is n1 by n2 is equal to r1 by r2. So now if we accumulate all the relations, we got this equation, relational equation. Next, so now we can able to get the load torque on the shaft. What is the actual torque it, the gear train arrangement is providing on the shaft? So when there is an intermediate torque which is experienced by the second wheel T21, it will going to make the wheel rotate by theta 2 angle or theta 2 angular displacement, which will be again opposed by the inertia coefficient of this follower wheel along with a viscous frictional coefficient B2. So now we can write a torque equation which is actually T21 minus J2 theta 2 double dot minus B2 theta 2 dot equal to TL. Again, from the relational operator, we know that the relation between T12 and T21 can be governed by the value of proportional number of teeth N1 and N2. So, we can write T12 equal to N1 N2 by T21. So, this is our first equation. From the first equation, if we substitute T12, we can get this value. Here, theta 1 are there, theta 2s are there. If we substitute this, we can get this value. We substituting this. Now, we can able to get, substitute the value of theta 2 with respect to theta 1 using the relational functions. So now we can get this equation, and from that we are getting the overall torque equation of the driving wheels. That is, this is the torque equation of a gear train arrangement. Thank you.